We want to simplify the given radical expressions involving square roots. And we'll see expressions like this when using the quadratic formula. The first step is going to be to simplify the square root. So in this case, we want to simplify the square root of 32. Remember, this will simplify if it contains any perfect square factors. Well, 32 is equal to 16 times 2, and 16 is a perfect square. The square root of 16 is equal to 4, so this simplifies to 4 square root 2. Remember, if we don't recognize our perfect square factors, we can always write out the prime factorization of 32. The prime factorization of 32 is actually 5 factors of 2. Every time we have two equal factors, we have a perfect square. So here's a perfect square, and here's a perfect square. Remember, to simplify this, we take one factor from each group. So this simplifies to 2 factors of 2 outside, which equals 4, and we're left with the square root of 2. Either way, it simplifies to 4 square root 2. So we can write this as 8 minus 4 square root 2 divided by 4. Now we need to be careful on this next step. We cannot just simplify this 8 and this 4 because we cannot simplify across, in this case, subtraction. So there are two ways to simplify this correctly. One way, since we're dividing by a monomial, is to divide each term in the numerator by 4. So we can write this as 8 divided by 4 minus 4 square root 2 divided by 4. Well, 8 divided by 4 is equal to 2. And here, 4 over 4 simplifies to 1, so we have minus square root 2. So this simplifies to 2 minus square root 2. The other way to simplify this correctly would be to take this form here and factor out the greatest common factor from the numerator. The greatest common factor would be 4, so we could write this as 4 times the quantity 2 minus square root 2, and then divide this by 4. And in this form, since this 4 is attached by multiplication, we can simplify this 4 and this 4, leaving us with 2 minus square root 2. Notice how the result is the same. I prefer the first method of simplifying by writing this as two fractions, but this method is also valid. But sometimes the result may be in a different form, which we'll see in the second example. So again, the first step here is to simplify the square root of 54. Well, 54 is equal to 9 times 6. 9 is a perfect square. The square root of 9 is 3, and the square root of 6 does not simplify. Or again, if we need to, we can write out the prime factorization of 54. We would have 1 factor of 2 and 3 factors of 3. Here's a perfect square factor, which again would simplify to 3 square root 6. So either way, we can write this as 12 minus 3 square root 6 divided by 6. And again, we cannot just simplify the 12 and the 6 here because we cannot simplify across addition or subtraction. So one method is to break this up into two fractions, 12 divided by 6 minus 3 square root 6 divided by 6. And 12 divided by 6 is equal to 2. Here the 3 simplifies to 1, the 6 simplifies to 2. So this simplifies to minus square root 6 divided by 2. Now let's take a look at the second method, and this will give us a different form of the simplified expression. Again, looking at just the numerator, notice how there's a common factor of 3, so we can write this as 3 times the quantity 4 minus square root 6 divided by 6, which we can write as 3 times 2. In this form, we can see that there's a 3 over 3 that simplifies to 1, leaving us with 4 minus square root 6 divided by 2. So this is considered simplified, and notice how it doesn't look quite the same as the expression in blue. So this is acceptable, but just to verify that it is the same, we have to break this up into two fractions where we have 4 over 2 minus square root 6 over 2. Notice how this first fraction does simplify to 2. So this is why sometimes there can be a little bit of confusion when simplifying expressions like this. These two forms are considered simplified, even though they do look a little bit different. So keep this in mind when applying the quadratic formula.